guy. I really do, you know? Like, we work together all day long. And we never tell each other how we really feel. I love you guys. Hey, you want this?
I can't believe that's Jeff. He's usually such a quiet, shy, normal guy. What happened? Well, obviously, this happened. Alcohol. But what is it about this stuff that can turn someone from Dr. Jekyll into Mr. Hyde? Why does alcohol make you drunk?
Come on, let's hear some music. Come on, everybody.
Well, let's go back to the beginning of the party and see just what happened.
No, I don't drink.
Oh, come on. Toast Dave's success.
Okay.
And Jeff will begin to feel the effects of that first drink almost immediately.
You see, most of the food and drink you ingest takes time to be broken down by your stomach and intestines before it enters your system. But alcohol doesn't get broken down.
It enters your system and goes to work right away. Only moments after that first sip, it begins to cause vasodilation. This is where the blood vessels just beneath your skin dilate or open up and allow more blood to reach the surface. As a result, your skin temperature rises and you get that warm, fuzzy feeling. You look flushed. If you continue to drink, you'll soon begin to feel the effects of alcohol on other parts of your body. But drunkenness is not a result of alcohol actually affecting any of these parts directly. When you get drunk, it's because alcohol is affecting only one organ. Your brain. Your brain is made up of a complex web of nerve fibers. Traveling along these fibers are chemical messengers called neurotransmitters. A neurotransmitter is kind of like a bike courier, picking up and delivering the messages that coordinate all of the functions and activities of your body. The alcohol molecule kind of acts like a roadblock. It stops messages from getting through by attaching itself to nerve fibers. This can cause many different problems depending on which part of your brain a block occurs.
Alcohol tends to affect the brain from the top to the bottom, starting with this area, the cerebral cortex. This area is the responsible...
Yeah, curses, where'd you get the nice brain?
This area is the responsible, planning ahead, decision-making part of your brain. When messages get blocked here, you feel more relaxed, less stressed, laid back.
You know, Persis, I've never had the guts to say this, but I think you're cruel.
You also begin to lose some of your inhibitions.
I've seen all of your segments 6 times. I mean, I think your segments are much better than Chris's and Mike's. I mean, you got that certain something.
If you continue to drink, then alcohol's effect will seep further into your brain until it hits your cerebellum. This area is responsible for coordinating all your muscle movements. If signals can't get through here...
Here, got your drink.
Guess who?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Here. Do you know how much this top cost me?
Intoxication of the cerebellum produces the typical jerky, uncoordinated movements of a drunk person.
Oh. Thanks a lot, buddy.
Of course, Pete.
50 stripes cost me, man.
Not to throw up and continue to drink, alcohol eventually finds its way down to your brainstem, right here. One of the things your brainstem controls is eye movement. When alcohol invades your brainstem, your eye muscles fall out of sync with each other, causing them to seem like they each have a mind of their own.
Persis, you never told me you have a twin sister.
Hi. My name is Jeff. I work with Persis.
The result is you're left seeing double. But that's the least of your worries if you continue to drink. You see, your brainstem is also responsible for regulating your autonomic functions. It controls things like your heart rate and breathing.
You can actually drink yourself to death if too much alcohol reaches your brainstem.
built-in safety switch. When it senses the alcohol level has become dangerously high, it hits the switch. And you lose consciousness before any real damage is done. It's your body's way of saying, you're cut off.
All I remember is toasting Dave, and then I woke up on this couch.
Blackouts like this, where you forget a large chunk of what happened the night before, are common when you overindulge. To understand why, think of your brain as a video camera.
A video camera records scenes around you, just like your brain records memories.
But when your brain gets flooded with alcohol, it's as if the pause button has been accidentally pressed.
You go right on partying, but unknown to you, none of your experiences are even being recorded.
Later, when you try and play back the events of that night in your mind, you find there's a big gap.
Hey, you, Jeff?
Yeah?
Yeah, a message for you.